In the previous video, we've drawn the simplest organic compound, methane, like this, with the four covalent bonds at right angles to each other. However, this is not a flat molecule. In reality, the four hydrogen atoms take up positions that are as far away from each other as possible, and that means that they form this kind of tetrahedral arrangement. You can see that it's not so easy to represent this 3D structure on a paper or a screen. To be clear about which atom is where, we draw the bonds that are in the plane of the screen or paper as regular lines, and bonds that come towards us as a solid wedge, and bonds that are behind the plane of the screen or paper with these dashes. Sometimes we call this a wedge-dash representation. Let's look at a more complex molecule. Have a look at how the configuration of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen in the molecule on the left translates from the 2D structure on the left into a 3D structure on the right. In particular, notice the tetrahedral arrangement of the four single bonds on each of the carbon atoms. We can represent this molecule in wedge and dash format as well. But here's an interesting question. This is yet another way of representing that same molecule, but is it the same molecule as this one? Or this one? Yes, it is. Single bonds between atoms allow rotation, and rotation around single bonds changes the conformation of the molecule. In biochemistry, we often talk about conformational changes, and what we mean is that the overall shape of a molecule changes by rotating parts of the molecule around one or several single bonds. At the same time, not all conformations are equally likely. Depending on the groups attached to the atoms that are joined by the single bond, some conformations bring those groups awkwardly close together. Those conformations are energetically unfavorable and are much less likely than those where bulky groups keep a maximal distance from each other. So much for single bonds. What about double bonds? The first thing we notice is that the geometry of the carbon atoms is different. If they form double bonds, the three atoms attached to the carbon atom are all in one plane. And that's why we call that geometry trigonal planar. Carbon atoms with one double bond always have this trigonal planar geometry. In contrast, carbon atoms with four single bonds always have a tetrahedral geometry. A very important difference between single and double bonds is that, as you've seen, rotation around a single bond is possible. A double bond does not allow rotation. The consequence is that the two carbon atoms that form the double bond and all four atoms directly attached to them lie in a single plane. An even more important consequence is that these two molecules are not identical. The two hydroxyl groups are on opposite sides of the plane in the molecule on the left, and on the same side in the molecule on the right. You cannot convert one to the other by rotating the molecule around the carbon-carbon bond. It's a double bond that does not rotate. So let's summarize. Carbon atoms with four single bonds have a tetrahedral geometry. Those with one double bond have a trigonal planar geometry. It is possible to rotate parts of a molecule about a single bond, and we call this a conformational change, but rotation about a double bond is not possible.